show up on time. Because Doris will be out there to tell you what to do, and I'll be up here telling you what to do, and I don't think you can get lost between there and here. We've had a few folks pray, but I have a word of prayer in a minute, and I'll ask Dustin and Diane to introduce everybody that's here, and we'll get right to lining you up where you're going to be. We'll run through it. We've seen sunshine, we've seen rain, we've seen hail, we've seen beautiful flowers, we've talked with friends and family. Your spirit has been among us, and we thank you for your presence, for your love, for your invitation to be your follower, and for that time in our life when we find that special person that we want to be our husband or our wife, our best friend, our soulmate. Come in the midst of celebration of love and pray tonight that you'll help us do all the details we need to take care of. We'll have a lot of fun. Tomorrow afternoon when we gather, that you will be most present and we'll enjoy the rest of their hearts. Marriage. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I guess, Bill, you're the referee there. If you can say it again.
They'll say it.
All right. Got the pea shooter out there. Okay. Then I'll ask, Bill, you can turn. I'll ask who gives Beth to be married to Dustin, and you can say anything but me and Ma. That did not work.
My wife and I.
That works.
Her mother
and I.
Her mother.
Whatever you two probably agree on is... Well, that's all right. You just don't want to say me and Ma.
I got you.
Dustin, see how that works? You do what the wife says.
I didn't even argue.
Keep that in mind. I will ask the congregation at that point to stand and take a vow to be faithful to you in prayer. I would suggest you give her a kiss and shake hands.
Come on in.
I will say something about the rings, and then complicated, I'll just reach out and do it. You will hopefully choose the right ring. And you'll repeat after me as you're putting this on her finger, okay? So you put yours on her hand. And when that's over, you just turn your hand over like that, and you get to select the other.
So I start with the other hand, that's what you said.
Never have quite had a foot that way, but I guess if that's what you want to say. Did y'all hear that? She's going to start with the upper hand. And then you get to mine, and you get to the other. All right. After that, then I will tell you.
Tell Mama to mind her own business. Go tell Mommy to mind her own business.
Should be out like out here, so when the pictures are taken, when she goes to turn around, if you will throw it over there or move it over there.
Oh, we're talking about my dress.
Yes.
Okay. Uh-huh. No, I'm worried about the singer's dress. I was wondering if she had a trail.
I'm not going to worry about the singer's dress. If we need to assign somebody to it. Close to being in the same line coming in. All right, so you're heading out.
Thank you, Sheila.
You're welcome.
Aren't they lovely?
Keep going.
Yeah, we were talking about you two.
Keep going.
If it's an order, I'll be there.
Let me ask you something.
It's the rule, Bill.
Okay.
At the very end, you know, and after they're outside, how do they, or out in the, are you going to dismiss the people, or?
Yeah, we'll have the ushers come back in.
And just start to dismiss them.
Okay. Yeah. Where are the ushers, by the way? I'll be with you guys. You'll be in the back, and as they're coming, they're going out. Each of you will come around the outside.
Walk out with you. Give me a hand. I'll walk with you. I'm walking with you.
Too high. You're too high.
Come that way, the way that you will be coming in. That should be, of course, last.
Elena, you're first.
First, with the receiving line, is it just Dustin and I, or is it all the party? Or?
Whatever you want. And if you don't have a receiving line,
right now, this is the first time. She's waiting again. You can't bring the
whole floor. She said, well, she's standing by
that
pool there because you'll be close to me.
Got it all. Thank you. Yeah, that was very good. Thank you.
It wouldn't happen if I realized it.
Thank you.
Where's Chris?
He's back there.
Yeah, isn't he supposed to be up there?
It's on video right now.
I'm going to shoot you from the knees up because your knees are a little wobbly. I don't think anybody... Yeah, we'll do that. Yeah, I've never seen it like that before, but I'm sure it's perfectly natural.
Like some wobbly knees.
Yeah, isn't that the truth?
You're doing great.
It's beautiful.
Look at that.
You missed that nice laugh. Do that again.
I'm sure it'll come out again.
Oh, that close-up was wonderful.
Yeah. No, that was, I don't know. That was something.
I've already learned about you.
Is there a gap here for...
Yeah, my sister.
No.
She's not here tonight.
She's not here.
Yeah. She'll be here.
We'll imagine that she's
there. Joanne, when they get to the door, I'll look to you to stand. And everybody else will follow you.
The missing maid of honor. Or...
Bridesmaid.
Okay.
Right there.
Imagine. Oh, that's wonderful.
Imagine.
Yeah.
Here they come.
Just come on down.
Oh my gosh.
Hey, good job, guys.
All right.
That's great.
Don't let her get away from you, Em. Don't let her get away, Em.
Good job, Olivia.
Go ahead.
We'll wait till whenever they're
ready. To
stand. Now everybody stand. Everybody sing your favorite song now.
What's your favorite song?
Well, maybe not.
Lovely.
Are you relaxed? You may be seated. At this point, we're trying to remember everybody to power down their cell phones and all that good thing and try to make sure mine's off in the office. Welcome, God, family, friends. I'll ask you if you still agree to marry each other. I'll ask who gives Beth to be married to Dustin, and you say your thing. Shake or kiss her and shake his hand. And sit down and join. You can do whatever you want to.
Gross.
And I'll have the congregation stand, take their bow, all right? Now, when we come up here, he'll take her flowers and take care of her dress. All right, we'll move up here.
Take care of me. My friends, take care.
Join hands. Do the hands.
What are you going to do with that? Pam. So, Olivia, are you going to be up here, just down and come back and sit with you?
Probably makes sense.
Yeah.
Because if not, a fight will break out.
But I'm worried about the kids.
Yeah, because the two of them will end up fighting or wrestling or something.
If they come down, I think today I'd be a miracle.
It's all right. We've had some guys who can pass out, you know. But you still get married.
You're not getting out of this, dear.
We just hold you up, move them out. Yes. Well, I'll tell you, we're going to have some fun. All right, let's see, where are we at? We're at the rings. Say the rings, left hands.
If you're on it,
To them. Turn over. Very, very good.
Okay.
Then I will pronounce that you are together. Okay. And I'll invite folks to pray with you as, depending on which side the singers are, I'll go to the other side. Okay. You come up here. And fix the dress. The singers will sing. You will do whatever you're going to do up here. Then I'll have a prayer blessing. So, at this point, we've had the prayer. Now, turn to the inside. Back to the end. Face each other. The kiss?
Does she fix the dress at this point?
Yes. She is your slave, servant.
I like it.
But only for this point of time. Now, I wouldn't do that. She might cut your hand off. If you want to practice kissing, you can. The camera's waiting. But no, well, I knew you were good. All right, face each other, face the congregation. Last time. I'll pronounce that you are Mr. and Mrs. Ed hits the music, and you're on your way.
You remember that?
Okay.
Go get him, Chris.
Okay. Good. Doris and I need your attention for just a few moments. We'll get you out of here.
Smoking. To have food in your room or set up a table in the hallway, and feel free to bring in things, and just so that nobody is faint from not having tomorrow, are your ladies coming at 11:30?
We are all having lunch at Mom's house at 11 o'clock, all the women, and we'll all arrive sometime before pictures.
And that includes the men?
I know, they're not invited with us.
Do not leave anything of value to our dressing room, in the car, because there'll be a lot of wedding guests, and some people could come in and take advantage of. A lot of people coming in and pick up some more souvenirs. So be responsible for all your purses, wallets, candles, etc.
As far as the Liberty candle and the bows and all that stuff, yes. Can we just kind of. Is it just lay there or should we be responsible for the Liberty candle and the side candles and the bows on the pews and all that? What's left?
Mothers, I would like to you to be out here and ready to go. You can be out here all afternoon. Come with you. Where you are at 20 hours.
ladies, the wedding party, including your bride and dad. I will need you to be in back of those doors, those ground doors, they will be shut. I need you to be in back of those doors at 25 after 2, and whoever is in front, watch for my signal to have you come through the doors, and then you'll line up like you did.
Where are we changing at?
I'll show you that in just a minute. And if you want to follow me after all the jam passes, I'll show you where the dressing rooms are. Is there any questions?
What's the suggestion for having a line or receiving line after, or do they not do that here?
That's up to the bride.
Okay.
I mean, I don't know, that was going to be my question. Do you think we should have them with the entire wedding party? And if you do, whether it goes back?
Lately, I'll tell you what has been mostly the bride and groom and parents.
Don't blame Samara if you have a habit of being late. Tomorrow's not one of those days.
Dustin.
Seriously, things do happen on the highway, whatever, so make sure you have some felt song phone numbers, trying to break down or whatever. Give us a call. We do want to try to start on time. Doris will show you where your messing at bar and some of that in the building. Some of them have a good time with our buses. Very special people in our midst.
Nobody's allowed to chew gum tomorrow.
It's well, you wedding.
Chew it up until the time you line up.
That's right. Don't forget to take it up. Get rid of it.
All right, if you'll follow Doris, she'll show you any other instructions for this evening before Doris takes. Restrooms, of course, are here and down the hallway. Everybody knows where you're going tonight.
Yeah. Does everybody know how to get there?
No.
No.
Nope.
Okay, good. Me neither.
Where are you going?
The Iron Skillet.
Oh, 30th Street.
What's that?
It's on 30th Street.
It's 30th Street.
It's 30th
I have directions, so if we want, if everybody's going to be ready to leave, and we kind of
I do know that.
It's an easy place to find.
Bless you.
If you just get to 30th Street,
West
hang around.
West
30th. If you get to 30th and go east, you'll talk to
West
30th.
A lot of folks go down Thames and Tibbs and up to 30th and make a right.
That's all the way over.
All right, if you follow Doris, she'll show you where it's
going. Oh, that's a good place
now. 85 Riverside Park.
No.
She's not going to listen to you.
I played it on Sarah.
Hey, Dustin.
Yeah.
Can you turn the doorknob, please?
Open the door.
Can you open it?
Open the door, Olivia.
And all my keys to the other office are.
Guys, we need you down here.
All right, let me see if Doris.
Olivia, can you open the door, honey? Can you turn the handle?
This has never happened.
Can you turn the handle for Pepe?
Is it dark in there?
No,
there's a light.
No. Emma.
Come here.
Emma, Olivia, can you open the door for Pep?